So, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this episode. And when you look at the heading, it says first 20 elements. And that basically tells us that we are going to be looking at chemistry part. And my friend, if you don't know this table, it becomes a challenge for you to calculate most of the numbers. And for my case here, my table size, I'm going to begin with elements. And that's the name of the element in that order. And then we look at the symbol. We look at the atomic number. You know, atomic number is the same as the number of protons. And then after that, we look at the electronic configuration, the arrangement of the electrons in the energy levels, and then the valence. The valence simply will be telling us, see, the amount of electrons that participate in a given chemical reaction. And those are the ones that are in the outermost energy levels. So now, members, I know most of you in different schools, they gave you a different method of how you can recall these elements, right from hydrogen down up to calcium, the 20th element. So members, recall and always get to know how to write them in their order, because if you mess up, you will not get it. So to begin with, let us begin with how we can find the hydrogen. Now, when you look at hydrogen, the symbol is H, okay? And helium, the symbol is He. When you go to lithium, it is Li. We go to beryllium, it is Be. We go to boron, it is B. Carbon, C. We go to nitrogen, so nitrogen is N. Oxygen, O. Fluorine, F. Neon, Ne. Sodium is Na. Magnesium, Mg. So slowly we go to aluminium, Al. Silicon, Si. Phosphorus, P. Are we together? Sulfur, S. Chlorine, Cl. Argon, Ar. Potassium, K. And then lastly, calcium with Ca. So if you can be able to recall how to write all these ones the way how they are, you'll be a very good student. So members, now we go to atomic number. Members, atomic number simply is just how they are arranged in their order. Atomic number, the number of protons in the nucleus of an atom. In the next episode, I'm going to show you how they are arranged inside. But for our case, we see hydrogen is the first. Helium is the second, lithium is the third, beryllium is the fourth. So in that matter, we just even write here the number of protons. They are the same arrangement. This is the, it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, how together? 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So we say calcium has 20 protons and hence atomic number 20. Atomic number Z is the same as the number of protons. Never be confused by anyone. Hope that one is very simple. Now, members, we go to our second column, electronic configuration, the arrangement of these electrons in the energy levels. You have to know that the first energy level will always take a maximum of 2. They can never go beyond 2. And the second energy level will always take a maximum of 8. So they can be 8, but can never exceed that. They can be 7, they can be 6, no matter what. But the whole thing is they must not exceed 8, and the first level should be 2 or less. And for our case, when you look at hydrogen here, you see it has only one electron and it has only one energy level. That means its electronic configuration is just like that. And we go to helium, for it has a maximum of 2. Are we together? So we go to 3. We can't write 3, because we said the first energy level must have 2 and the rest will find themselves in the next energy level. You get the point? So the next energy level will have 1. So that 2 plus 1 will give you a 3. Are we together? So we go to four. So you first fill the first energy level with two, and then the others will go to the second energy level. So on, two to three, because two plus three will give you five. So we go to six. This is two to four. We go to seven. This is two to five, because two plus five is seven. So we go to eight, two to six. Let's go slowly. Now we go to nine. Are we together? So we have nine. That means it's two to seven. We go to 10. It is two to eight. You see this one now? This is the maximum number of electrons that can occupy the second energy level. That means when we approach to the 11th one, we are not going to say 2 to 9, because 9 cannot go there. So we shall say 2 to 8 to 1. 2 plus 8, 10 plus 1, 11. And so on, 2 to 8 to 2. 2 to 8 to 3. 2 to 8 to 4. Are we together? Hope you are enjoying. 2 to 8 to 5. 2 to 8 to 6. 2 to 8 to 7. Are we together? 2 to 8 to 8. So you see, this is now the third energy level has reached the maximum height. Because even the third energy level must have a maximum of height. So therefore, when we go to the 19th element, it is here. Let it first focus. 19th element, we shall not say 2 to 8 to 9. No, we shall say 2 to 8 to 8. Those are how many? That's 18 to 1. 19. So we got 2 to 8, that is 10, 18, 20. You get the point? And then we have reached the 20th element. Now, members, if you can recall how to draw these, and you can always pause the video and go back to know how to write the electron configuration, because they normally ask it. So we go to the valence, members. Now, the valence, those are the number of electrons that are going to participate in a given chemical reaction. Now here, the only thing you can do is just to look at what is in the outermost energy level. I'm going to show you. People get confused here. Here the valence is moja. The valence is two. You just pick this one. Here the valence is one, the most energy, outermost energy level. This one is two. This one, you know, sometimes it focuses and it takes time. This is now three. Are we together? Now this is four. Okay. So when we reach the fifth one, note, please note very carefully. When you reach the fifth one, always subtract eight from that one. Just come here and say eight minus five, because we know here the maximum must be eight. So when you reach, you say eight minus five, you get three. When you reach here, you say 8 minus 6, you get 2. That's the valence. Are we together? Very interesting. 8 minus 7, you get 1. When you reach here, you say 8 minus 8, the valence here is 0. You get it. And now these ones, they are less than 5. 1, 2, are we together? 3, 4. But now when you reach 5, we go back to the other one. 8 minus 5, we get a 3. 8 minus 6, we get a 2. You get it? 8 minus 7, we get a 1. 8 minus 8, we get a 0. So these ones are less than 5. We just write the way they are. Have you gotten it clearly? I can repeat for you. This is a 1. This is a 2. Because these ones are less than 5. You get it? Here, the maximum must be 8, remember. But you have not reached 8. So you just pick 1, the valence, 2, is the valence, 3 is the valence, 4 is the valence. But when you reach 5, just subtract the remaining ones that are supposed to make 8 becomes the valence. And note this figure that is there. But what is remaining to reach 8? You get the point. So that's my major concern. And the rest are this as a very simple. So members, if you can be able to get to know this table, trust me, even the work that is going to proceed is going to be very simple very interesting. Thank you for listening.